Good afternoon, church family. Today is Monday, the 22nd of November. It is the Monday before Thanksgiving, and I am so glad to be able to connect with you today. This has been such a joy. It's been going on almost 2 years that I've done an update each and every week, or if I haven't done it, Pastor Aaron has stepped in and done it for me. And I love the opportunity to communicate with you one more time each and every week and be able to bring to attention some things that you might need to know or you might be concerned about or whatever it is. And so I'm so grateful for this opportunity. Thank you for those of you who are still tuning in. And for those who aren't, you're not going to know it anyway because only those that are tuning in are seeing it. So God bless you today. I'm so glad to be with you. And I just have some things that I'd like to talk to you about. And then I'd like to end today praying for a situation. So we'll start off by just let me run through this week. This is a different kind of week because it is Thanksgiving week. And so let me just tell you that choir practice this week is tomorrow night, Tuesday night at 6:30 here in the choir room. It will not be on Wednesday night. We don't have anything going on Wednesday here at the church. And so choir practice is tomorrow evening. Thursday is our community Thanksgiving meal. And so that meal will be between 11 o'clock and 1 o'clock, 11 in the a.m. and 1 in the p.m. And so surrounding the lunch hour, there's opportunity for anybody in our community to come and eat Thanksgiving dinner on us or Thanksgiving meal on us. And so we want to invite you out. Those of you who signed up to volunteer, please make sure that you remember your commitment and show up. We are expecting you. And so thank you for the volunteers. And if you haven't volunteered, but you'll want to, you're welcome to come up between the 11 and 1 o'clock hour and just say, hey, what do you need me to do? Or if you can come at 1 o'clock and say, hey, can I help you clean up? I'm sure that something can be done. So if you didn't volunteer, if you haven't signed your name up, but you'd like to be a part, please don't let that stop you. Come out and be a part of our Thanksgiving community dinner. And so that's this Thursday. And then this coming Sunday is the first Sunday of Advent. I'm so excited about that. And so we'll have an Advent reading each week. We'll have a lighted candle each week. In fact, even today, we have a whole group of folks who are transforming our sanctuary from pre-Thanksgiving to Advent decorations. And so I'm grateful for them. When you come in on Sunday, you'll see us decorated for Christmas. That doesn't happen magically. It doesn't happen by your staff. It's volunteers from our church who come and do that. And so we're excited for them and for that. So that's this Sunday. The next four Sundays, beginning this Sunday, will be Advent. It will culminate with our Christmas Eve service on Friday night, the 24th of December. And so that's at 5 o'clock. We'll have our Lord's Supper celebration. We'll have a candlelight portion. We'll sing. We'll tell the Christmas story, all of that. So that's the culmination of Advent on Christmas Eve, the 24th, which is a Friday this year. The Sunday before that, on the 19th of December, is going to be a special choir-driven program. It's not a full cantata like our choir normally does. We didn't have an opportunity to work on that. They have prepared three special songs. We'll have one solo. We'll have some congregational singing. The kids are going to sing. And so there should be a good day that day on December the 19th. So please make plans to be with us that last Sunday of Advent and the last Sunday before our Christmas Eve service. And then let me just tell you about one other thing that's ongoing. It happens year-round, but I just want to remind you of it. It's a way that you get to know our church, to get to plug in. So if you're a new member and you haven't availed yourself of this, or if you're a guest and you'd like to connect with us, or maybe you're a longtime member and you've just never given yourself over to this, let me just encourage you. Our Sunday school is where it's at. Three things happen through our Sunday school, and these three things are Every church has to do these three things. We just use Sunday school to do it. If we didn't have Sunday school, we'd have to find another way to do these three things. And so the first is biblical literacy. And so we actually have Bible lessons in our Sunday school classes. And so it's built around a thematic study of Scripture, whether it's a life study or whether it's a Bible book study. These studies take you through God's Word thematically. And so we'd ask you to be a part of that just so you can learn God's Word, so you get to know it better, so you understand the story of Scripture. The second thing that it does is it puts you in a small group session where you can know each other. You can learn one another. You can learn from one another. And so you have to do this to be a part of a church, to be in a smaller group where you hold one another accountable to the teaching of God's Word. And so this is where we do it mainly, is in our Sunday school class. And then the third thing that it does is it avails it gives ourselves over to ministry. So often when ministry needs to take place, it's those Sunday school classes that are the front line of our ministries. Certainly our staff attempts to minister to our church family. Certainly I try to minister to our church family. But ultimately that ministry begins and often ends with these small groups, these Sunday school classes. And so if you want to connect with our church, if you want to be a part of the ministry of our church, if you want to be a part of taking meals to those who are in need, or to praying over those who are hurting, or whatever the situation is, often that starts and ends in our Sunday school classes. So let me just encourage you. We have four co-ed classes of varying ages, varying life stages, but we actually have four different co-ed classes. Now, used to, we might call them couples classes, and certainly we have many couples that belong to these classes, but they really are co-ed. So we have some single guys and some single ladies who are also a part of these classes. You don't have to be married to be a part of one of our co-ed classes. So that's why we call them co-ed. We have four of those. We have one senior adult men's class. And senior adult, I think probably the youngest is 65 or so in that class. And so that's a good place for our senior adult men. We have a senior adult ladies class. And it is probably a little younger than the men's class. Maybe 55 or 50 are the youngest ladies there, but then on up into the spectrum. So we have one of those classes. And then we have one not senior adult ladies class. And so this is all the other ladies. Younger than that, they have one ladies class for that. And so both of those ladies classes are dynamic. They have great teachers. The Bible studies are relevant and accurate. And so I just invite you to avail yourself to one of those classes. And then we have age-graded youth and children's classes for those. We have a nursery. So all the other ages younger than adulthood are represented. We also have a young adult class, which is, in my day, we would have called it the college and career class. Now we just call it a young adult class, but it's for those who are out of high school and who are either in college or they're starting their careers, that age group. And so we have lots of opportunities, lots of groups to connect with. And we invite you to be a part of one of those things. So go out and find your place in First Baptist. Find where you fit, and then plug in and begin to be a part of our ministry there. And so that's really the messages that I wanted to bring to you today. I told you earlier that I wanted to end with a time of prayer. If you're not watching this on Monday, the 22nd of November, 2021, then this may be just old news. But yesterday, in Wisconsin, during a Christmas parade, a person drove a car into the parade and killed five people, was the count that I've seen so far, and injured many others. Just a horrific and senseless act. As of this time, they have someone in custody. They haven't charged that person yet. I don't even know if that's the right person that they have. Only the police, in conjunction with the court system, and ultimately a jury, will decide if that's the right person or not. But this is just a horrific and senseless act. Families gathered together just to celebrate Christmas, to kick off the Christmas season, and to see that happen. And what we're seeing is more and more of this kinds of senseless violence, senseless rage in our nation. And it's really worldwide, but it's especially evident in the United States of America. We have become a nation that's unhinged. We don't have a mooring of what right and wrong look like. And it's just getting worse. And so I'd like to do this. I'd like to pray for our nation, but I'd like to pray specifically and primarily for those in that small Wisconsin town. I would call the name, but I don't know quite how to pronounce it. This small Wisconsin town where the whole community was crashed into by one person who we don't know why they did it yet. And it doesn't really matter why. What they did was wrong, and what they did was senseless, violent, and it changed forever a community and changed forever these families, especially the ones who lost loved ones. So if you would, just pray with me. This caught me by surprise, but it didn't catch God by surprise. We can trust Him, and we need to trust Him with these hurts and these needs. So if you would, just bow with me. I won't pray long, but I ask you to pray with me. Lord Jesus, I ask that you would do what only you can do, and that is that you would heal the brokenhearted, that you would comfort the hurting, that you would minister to those who are in need of ministry. Lord, I pray that you would bless this town. Lord, I pray that as they try to come to grips as to what happened yesterday in their annual Christmas parade, Lord, I pray that you would be with them, that you would minister to them, that you would give them grace. Lord, I pray for these families who lost loved ones. Lord, we recognize that the holidays will never be the same. They'll never be the same for these families, and probably for this community. So, Lord, we just ask that you'd minister, that you would give grace, that you would extend healing to those who are affected by this. And, Lord, we pray that this Christmas season would be a time of hope, that people would put their trust in you this Christmas season. Lord, I pray for our nation. I pray that you would do a work. God, I pray that you would bring an awakening to those who have never been spiritually awakened, that they would see their need for a Savior, that they would hear the good news of Jesus, his supernatural birth, his perfect life, his substitutionary death in our place, and his glorious resurrection, his victory over death, hell, and the grave, and the way that we can be saved if we would just put our faith in Him. And so, Lord, I pray that this season would be a season of hope. Lord, I pray that you would bring this awakening to our nation, but, Lord, also a time of revival for those of us who claim Jesus as Lord, for those of us who say we belong to Him. Lord, I pray that we would be reignited in our passions for Him, that we would be the salt and light that He has called us to be, that we would be that city on a hill shining a light into a dark place. And so, Lord, I pray that you would have your way with us, that you would do a work in our nation, and Lord, I pray that you would bless us for Jesus' sake. So we ask it in His name. Amen. Church family and community of who join in every week to watch this update, I pray that this holiday season would be a time of great blessing, that we would be grateful and thankful this week, And that in the weeks to come as we approach Christmas, that we would truly have a Merry Christmas because Jesus would be front and center in the way that we celebrate and in our lives, not just during this season, but really all year long. Church family, I love you. I'm so grateful to be your pastor. It's such a joy to be able to lead such a people that we are. And community, I want you to know that I love you too. I'm grateful to be able to speak into your lives, even if I'm not your pastor. But if you need a pastor, if you need a church home, a church that you can call home, a family to belong to, come out to First Baptist, give us a try. We'll love you, and we will try to share the gospel with you in lots and lots of different ways. So God bless you. Have a great week. Happy Thanksgiving. Have a good week. Please continue to pray for those in Wisconsin who are affected by this tragedy. And let's continue to go to the Lord for our hope. Have a great week.